Hey guys. So the tiger's done. There's not much that I want to do to it now. Later, I may come back and do to it, but I do that with all my builds. I may come back and do something. I can see a couple of things that I probably will come back and do, but right now, I won't. The only reason is because I was becoming bored with it. Not with the tiger. The tiger was fantastic. I was becoming bored with the diorama. When you start doing that, it's best to stop and say, that's enough. I thankfully reached the point where I was becoming bored at the point where I could stop and say, it's done. So I could go further if I wanted to, but I don't want to. Not now, anyway. Maybe some other time I will. But it's at a state now where I can happily say, yeah, that's finished, and just leave it like that. If I push it too far now, I'll probably just screw it up. The reason why I was becoming bored with it is because my mojo starts to slip. I tried a bunch of different new things with this, and when I do that, the look of the diorama starts to bother me. And even though I know that there's really nothing horribly wrong with it, I can see things that aren't supposed to be there, or they're not so actually supposed to look like that, and they start to bug me. And when things start to bug me, I lose interest in them. And that was starting to happen, so I decided that's enough. The tiger itself, the kit itself, was probably the best tiger kit and styrene that I've built. The kit was not my build of it. It's the best kit that Dragon's ever done, that's for sure. The molds, the detail, the new parts, the new tooling, everything's all top drawer. And I highly recommend the kit to anyone who wants to buy it. But what I recommend more is that you wait until they pop out the next edition of the kit that doesn't have those gimmicky figures. You'll save some money. The figures are extremely limited in scope, and you can only use them for one scene. So they serve really no purpose unless you're going to build that one scene and that scene only. They're not even valuable as a collector. So I can't see why anyone would want to collect that. It doesn't make any sense to me. I wouldn't want to collect it. I just wouldn't see any value in something like that. If it was an assortment of Wittmann heads and Bobby Wall heads, an assortment of different arms and torsos and stuff like that that came in a bag, oh, definitely I would want that. I'd pay good money for something like that. But it's such a fixed pose. No, there's no value in that thing. So anyone who's buying these kits hoping to sell them on because they're collector's items, you're wasting your money. We got more interested in the tiger, not in the figures, I think, as tiger builders. And when they pop out the next version of this kit, and I'm hoping they're still going to do that, and it doesn't have the figures in it, that's what people are going to want. At least that's what I'm going to want, and that's what I'm waiting for. I'll probably buy a couple of them. I have zero interest in the figures. And most of the people I've talked to, they have no interest in the figures at all. So it'll be nice because I'm hoping it'll knock $10 or $15 off the price of the kit. And that makes this kit extremely affordable and really worth its money. So that would be cool. Knocking $5 off of the kit is not good enough. It wouldn't make me want to buy it. I'd actually not buy it if they only knocked $5 off the kit. The figures are worth more than that. $10 at least. So to buy a five-figure set, it's like $15, $18. So, you know, they need to knock something like that off. So as a kit, though, itself, the tiger itself, it was a beautiful kit to build, and I recommend that to anybody. What else? The diorama, well, you know, I tried a bunch of different things. The grass tufts, like this one here, and the one back by the idler back there, and there's another one right here. there's a, I think a fourth one in there somewhere. I think it's behind the rock wall. They came from an eBay dealer, a guy who makes the bases for wargaming figures. And I bought them. It came in a box. I think it was like 12 or 14 of them. It was in a box. And it was like $8.99 for them. And they come in different types. It's like summer, winter, fall, spring, and desert, and tropical, and I think all kinds of different ones. And they're really, really nice because they're all different, right? And they got flowers on them, rocks, moss, sticks. And all. They're really detailed. And it's definitely worth the money to buy those for me. And I added them to the diorama because I wanted to see what they would look like. And I was really impressed with them. Definitely, I'll be buying more of those. This rock wall in the back, that's just a piece of cardboard with a new kind of modeling clay stuck to it. Dutch modeling. Sebastian Schoof donated some from, it comes from the Netherlands. It's really, really cheap where he is. And it's very similar to Fimo, but it's less sticky. It's a lot less spongy, and it's more dense. So it's for me anyway, I find it easier to work with. And I made the rock wall out of it, and I liked it quite a bit. I'll probably be seeing if I can hit Sebastian up for more of that stuff. It was really good. So thanks for that, Seb. It was really cool stuff. I was very happy with how it turned out. The patterning on the rock wall, the bricks and stuff you see on there, I did that just with a stamp. Take the end of a paintbrush, cut the bristles off, and then I hollow out the end so it's like a cup, and I just use that. I push it into the clay and it makes a rock shape. I usually make two of them, and I make the, so I only have two different shaped rocks, and I just stamp the crap out of the thing. The base itself, it's just DAS modeling clay, the air dry modeling clay. I shaped it to the ground shape that I wanted. Then I added the kitty litter and the sand, different kinds of sand, and some talus and some small stones and stuff to it, and a few sticks. Then I painted the whole thing, or it was all tied in with liquefied white glue. Waited for that to dry, and then I primed it all with crappy Vallejo primer, the black primer, because it's good for shadows. Then I painted the whole thing a sandy yellow color, actually this color here on this rock wall. Then I added a brownish color. Actually, I don't know if you can see it. It's actually kind of in there, that brown color there. It's a dark brownish color for modeling it, just to give it a bit of tonal variety, make it look like it was freshly turned earth. Then I sprayed all the areas where I wanted grass to go with an olive green and some NATO green. And then I coated the thing with some liquid white glue again and added the static grass and all these grass tufts. And then a few bunch of sticks and some oregano and thyme, parsley, some coriander, and sprinkled that everywhere. Then I added these trees in the back here, which I got from M. Forbes Hutton and Rodney Hickey. I don't know where Rodney gets these ones here, these brown ones, somewhere in Newfoundland. But Forbes got these from MK35 in France. That's where those came from. Bergenglia or something like that, I think they're called. Here they call it baby's breath, but I don't know what they call it over there. It's Bergenglia or something like that, I can't remember. And then I sealed everything with hairspray and added some more pigments, just to add some dusty sort of effects. Added the vehicles and figures, and then added pigments to them to blend them into the surface. Then I added some exhaust staining to the back of the tank. And then that was it. I called it done at that point. There wasn't anything else I wanted to do. And it was at that point I was becoming somewhat bored with it now. I've got a strong mojo to do a bunch of other builds right now. Builds I have no business doing. Like, I have an AT-ST, one of those Star Wars AT-STs from Bandai. And I want to start that, but I'm not allowed to start it yet because Paul Breton won't let me. And I got actually a bunch of Star Wars kits I want to start building, right? But I'm not allowed. Because the Star Wars thing doesn't start till May. So, but, you know, these things are distracting me right now. You know, I'm very impulsive. And I just do things sometimes. So anyway, now that this is done, I'm either going to put the moose jaw back on the bench, or I'm going to try and start working on the HMCS Halifax. So those are the only things that I'm going to start working on. I got the Panther already on the paint bench right now, and it's going to be primed. Probably not today. Maybe the next day. I'll probably have it primed and the base coat painted on it. I'm going to go for a really tight color on that. It's going to be battered all to hell. It's going to be the most beat up vehicle I've ever done. So it should be interesting. So, anyway, that's it for this thing. I'm going to do a short slideshow, just a minute or two. And you can see the build of this thing on the forum. There's a 4 or 5 page long build thread on this. If you want, you're not going to find too much of the stuff on Facebook about this. I posted a little bit on there. But I'm not going to post a whole lot of stuff on Facebook anymore. I find it's just kind of a waste of time. The reason I posted anything on Facebook was to try and get people to come to the forum. Because I would post my work, and then I would write a description of what it is I had in the post, and then put a link in there to the video, if I had one, and to the forum thread that was regarding the work. But what would happen is people wouldn't read what I wrote. They would just look at the pictures and then write a comment. And that was it. I find that to be a waste of my time. And to be honest, it's a waste of your time. You guys got better things to do than do that. So I'm not going to post stuff on Facebook anymore because it's actually a waste of my time. It's not doing what I wanted to do, and that's try and get people to go to the forum. So I'm not going to post anything there, really. It just doesn't serve any. If I do, it'll be I'll post a link to what I'm doing on the forum. I'm not going to post pictures anymore. So, like I said, waste of time. And if nobody wants to follow those links, then fine, they won't. But that's cool. Facebook is a Space Cadet Academy, so I don't like spending a lot of time on it if I can avoid it. It's not what I was hoping it was going to do. I really thought it would work, but it didn't. Anyway. What else? Anything else? No. That's it. Okay. So, this is it. On to the slideshow. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.